think I had plenty of dreams and light in my life. Still my glass was half empty, but you came along and showed me how to love without limits, to have a good time. Is anyone else's dog obsessed with ice? I did not mean for that many ice cubes to fall out of the ice dispenser, but I think it was because I had it on crushed. But I wanted to show you guys my new favorite way to make coffee. Oh my gosh. I've showed you guys the Premier Protein little hack, but this coffee, Adam got me hooked on it. It is so good and smooth and like sweet. It's not bitter at all. And all you need is 1 tablespoon of it. That's it. 1 tablespoon, and then I pour the rest. I mix the rest with Premier Protein. They gave me a discount code for this stuff too, for 20% off. I think one bottle is $24, but you can get 14 uses out of one bottle because all you need is 1 tablespoon. It comes with a tablespoon too. They send you this, which is really cute. So with my discount code, it makes it like $1 a cup of coffee. That's it. Super inexpensive. And it takes me 2 seconds to make my coffee in the morning, and it's really, really good. A lot of you guys said to try the, there's a few flavors you guys said, but I love the caramel one. Once we run out of these, I'm gonna try a new flavor, but I honestly don't even need any other cream or anything. It's sweet enough as it is, and you guys know that I love my coffee really sweet. But that is it. So, so easy and so delicious. So I'll have this link below if you guys want to try it. I have to share these leggings with you guys because these are not by Blanky. These are by Stork, Stork Hue. And I've been living in these for like the last few weeks, and I don't see myself going back to Blanky or Blanky. I don't really know how you say it. Because these are really, really, really stretchy and a lot easier to get on and over the bump. As you guys know, I talk about them all the time. The Blanky leggings, I have like 6 pairs of them because I love them so much and they're super supportive. But at this point in pregnancy, like, it's so hard to get dressed in the morning. And these are like extremely stretchy and they're just a different material. So I think I'm going to order like 1 more pair of these because I'm going to probably live in them until I give birth. It's probably going to be pretty cold up until I give birth to her, and it's just so hard to get the Blanky ones on. Like, they're comfortable once you put them on, but it's really difficult to get on and over the bump. So I just wanted to recommend these if you guys are pregnant, especially in the third trimester. These ones by Stork are really, really nice. And this sweatshirt is coming to Typically Blush next week, I think, so stay tuned. It's so cute and extremely good quality. I've already washed and worn this a few times, and I'm just like so impressed with the quality of our pullovers. So we make all of our graphics in-house now, and in the middle there you can see the TV logo. So stay tuned, this is coming soon, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna have sizes extra small through 3X.
Did you ever stop and think, why spend too much time just getting ready? Let me be honest, I don't know a single thing that I haven't done to make you notice me. Let me be real here. When I see you, my heart starts racing, but I don't know if I like this chasing and playing and waiting around. It's a shame that my hands start shaking all of the time when you're around me. But this time, this time, girl, I know what's bothering me. I need somebody to love. Oh, nah, 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 nah. Don't you see what's wrong with me? I need somebody to love. Oh, oh, nah, nah. I don't know what I could say much that I'm still keeping to myself. Cause you don't listen, babe, but still you got me missing you. When I see you, my heart starts racing, but I don't know if I like this chasing and playing and waiting around. It's a shame that my hands start shaking all of the time when you're around me. But this time.
So here's everything I'm putting in the kids' Valentine's Day baskets this year. It's not a lot, but I know that they'll love them. So I honestly just use baskets that we had around the house. That's why Grayson's is a little bit smaller, but he can't have like treats and stuff, so his stuff fit in there perfectly. These baskets are honestly too big for everything that I got for the girls, but they work. You don't have to go out and buy a new basket just to throw it away. So we reuse these baskets obviously for so many different things around the house. So anyways, I will link everything down below in the description box if you need ideas. But I got them each a coloring book and a new book. So hi Chloe. I'll link both of these books down below. They're from Amazon, The Pink Umbrella. And then I got them some M&Ms. This is little LOL gummy ball, some heart glasses that they can wear this spring and summer. Those are from Amazon. Some hair scrunchies, lip gloss. They're both really into lip gloss right now. And then some Annie's fruit snacks. I didn't give them a ton of candy, just the M&Ms and the gummies. But I did the same exact thing for both of their baskets. I just changed out the book because you have girls similar in age, you know, if you don't get them the same thing, they will fight over it. These are their Valentine's for their class. So I just stuck that in there just so I don't forget to give that to them this week for school. But that is everything I'm putting in their basket. Nothing crazy. And then for Grayson, he's really into balls right now and throwing. So I got him this really cute truck ball from Amazon. I got him this little red car. He loves like rolling cars around on the floor. And then this is a color changing car. I've never seen the movie. He's never seen the movie, but I thought he would like that. I got him some creamies because he can't really have candy. And I stuck some Annie's fruit snacks in there for him too. And then I got him a new book, How to Catch a Dinosaur. I got that from Amazon as well. So that is everything that I'm putting in the kids' baskets this year. Everything will be linked down below if you need ideas.
I have a checkup for Tatum coming up soon, and my doctor told me at my last checkup that I need to make a decision on whether or not I want to be induced or go into labor naturally on my own by this next appointment. I have to let him know. And I have been thinking about it. I've actually been thinking about it since, like, honestly, since we got pregnant. Just because I don't know if this is going to be our last baby. I'm pretty sure it's going to be. And a part of me just wants to be able to experience going into labor on my own without being induced. So I was induced with Shay and with Grayson, and I had really great experiences as far as induction goes. The epidural obviously wore off with both of them, and it was pretty intense, but the induction process was not bad. It was actually really nice to be able to prepare, especially when you have other kids at home. So I'm not against induction at all, and I may end up going through with an induction this time. I'm just leaning more towards going into labor on my own naturally. So the only baby that I've done that with is with Bailey, and I was not on YouTube then, but my labor with her, like, you guys, if you've seen my last two birth vlogs, they were very, very intense, and my labor with Bailey was like 10 times that, if you can believe that. So I had her naturally. For those of you guys that are new here, went into labor on my own. She was my first at 40 weeks in 5 days, so she was 5 days overdue. And I was in labor for 3 days, so like 72 hours with very, very, very painful contractions, and my body just could not get past 4 centimeters. And we were stationed in 29 Palms at the time. My husband was in the military, in the Marines, and their protocol at that hospital that I gave birth to was you have to be at least 5 centimeters in order to get admitted. I will leave my birth story with Bailey down below. I don't have an actual birth vlog with her because, like I said, I wasn't on YouTube at the time, but I did film a sit-down video explaining my birth story with her. So they sent me home like 3 times and I was in excruciating pain. And I just wanted the epidural so bad because I was in so much pain, but they kept sending me away because my body wasn't in active labor at that point. And then, I don't know why I'm re-explaining this to you guys, but in case you don't want to watch that video, I'll just kind of sum it up really quickly. I went back, I think this was the 3rd time, just in like agony, so much pain, and begging the nurse to admit me. And she checked me again. She told me that I was still only 4 centimeters. And so she was like, just go walk the halls. Before, they kept sending me home. This time she was like, go walk the halls and don't come back here unless it's been at least 2 hours. And so I got dressed and Adam and I started walking the halls, and 30 minutes later I felt her coming out of me. And I remember this so vividly. I found the nearest chair I could and like tensed up on all fours like a feline cat and started like pushing her out. And poor Adam, this was our first baby, so we honestly had no idea what to expect. He was like, what in the world are you doing? And I was like, I need to go back to labor and delivery. She's coming out of me. And he was like, we can't go back. It hasn't been 2 hours yet. And I was like, I don't care. She's coming out of me. It had only been like 30 minutes at this point. Ran back in to triage, and they just looked at me and kind of like shook their head. Like, they were kind of annoyed at me at this point because I kept coming in. And they put me back in triage, checked me, and sure enough, she was coming out. I was pushing her out, fully dilated. And I just remember looking at the nurse like, can I please get my epidural now? And she was like, oh, sweetie, you're way past that point. I'm sorry, you're having this baby naturally. And I just totally blacked out and ended up having Bailey in my clothes that I came in with. No IV, no hospital bracelet, no gown, nothing. I had her on the bed in triage in like 5 seconds. And she came out with a broken collarbone because of how fast she came out. I wasn't coached on like how to push or anything. She flew out. And that whole experience was very traumatizing for me, which is why I chose to get induced with Shay and then again with Grayson, just to kind of like avoid all of that. Because with Bailey, I progressed from 4 to 10 in like 30 minutes. So that was why my doctor and I felt it was best to get induced. But I don't know. I kind of wanted to see how this labor progresses on its own. And I think it would be really special just because this is probably our last baby, like I said, and I want to see how my body's able to go into labor on its own without having to be put on any medication to get my body to go into labor. So that is where I'm at right now. I talked to Adam about it, and it's obviously going to be a lot harder because we don't have any family out here. We're in Dallas, my family is in California, and Adam's family is in South Dakota, so they're not even like driving distance, like our driving distance wise, so they have to fly in to stay with us when we have our babies. And that's the only thing that's kind of pushing me for an induction, just so that we can plan for either Adam's mom or dad or my mom or dad to come and stay and watch the kids while we go to the hospital. But I don't know. You guys know we have a nanny now, and so I'm hoping if I do choose to go into labor naturally that I go in during the week while she's here and she'll be able to watch the kids for us. But I mean, you never know when your body's gonna go into labor, so I don't know. I'm leaning more towards not getting induced, but that could change, but I have to let my doctor know at my next appointment. But that is where I'm at currently, and so I think I'm just gonna tell my doctor that I wanna wait and go from there. So if anything changes, I will let you guys know, but that is the update on that.
Wish I could say I was finally over you, but that's not the truth. Everyone always keep falling in love again. What's wrong with them? stand. Maybe it will pass by, someone save me, for I pass out, I'm too lonely to be done, I'ma drink at this page.
Come on, little foxy boy. Hi. Come on.
What did you learn at school today?
How to sing happy birthday in Spanish.
In Spanish? I can't even sing that in Spanish.
What?
Show me.
Cumpleaños feliz. Cumpleaños feliz. Cumpleaños feliz. Cumpleaños feliz. Eat my cake!
You learned that today?
Yeah.
Good job, honey. I love you. I'll see you in the morning. I just asked you guys on Instagram if you have any good recommendations for a belly support band. I've never needed one, but she is seriously so low. It feels like she's gonna fall out, and my lower stomach and my lower back are starting to really like ache, especially my lower stomach. She's just like so heavy and putting so much pressure down there. So if you guys have any good recommendations, let me know in the comments. I'm hoping that it'll help. Adam said he saw some video, I think it was on TikTok or something, where this girl's husband went up behind her and like lifted up her pregnant belly to like give her some relief, and then like slowly dropped it. And so he tried it on me the other day, and now I ask him to do it like all the time because it feels so good to have that pressure like relieved for a second. So I'm hoping a belly support band will help, but feeling very pregnant these days. 33 weeks in a couple days. I made an appointment to go see Tatum in 3D40, like a 3D40 ultrasound on Saturday. So I'm really looking forward to that appointment. But every time I get ultrasounds of her, she's always like smushed up right next to my placenta. So I'm hoping she's in a good position at that appointment so we can get a good shot of her. But anyways, I'm gonna end the vlog here. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to give it a thumbs up if you did. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. Why am I the only one who's been-